we have reports that they were lied to, that they were tricked, that they were induced with false promises to get on planes and then shipped someplace where they weren't told where they were going. That, to me, is a violation of the federal kidnapping statutes. The legal term of art is inveigling. As I think most people can kind of, their horse sense can kind of understand. If I roll down and find a bunch of teenagers and I say, look, kids, hop in my van, I'm going to take you to Disney World, and I take them to Busch Gardens, and I take them to Old Williamsburg, that's kidnapping. I didn't take the kids where I said I was going to take the kids, right? So I think that in this case, Ron DeSantis told these people, including children, that we take them to one place, Boston, which would have services where they would get expedited work visas, where they would be have housing, and then sent them to a different place. That is kidnapping. And the person that we need to understand that is, unfortunately, at this point, not Ron DeSantis, not Greg Abbott. We need Merrick Garland. Once again, to understand that and bring the full weight of the power of the federal government down on these people.
I'm not sure it's actually even kidnapping. Like, if you hold someone against their will and take, like, you don't let them leave, I don't know. That seemed like a little bit of a stretch.
Yeah, I mean, there are.
It can be bad
kind of
without
constructive kidnapping cases like that. I think that, lawyers, there's an investigation, so the lawyers will decide what this actually amounts to. I don't know why the Busch Gardens slander had to be in there. I don't know what Busch Gardens ever did to LA Mistel. Some of us really enjoyed that as a vacation destination as children. But we got a different take altogether from Charlamagne the God. Let's take a listen to that.
I personally think it's genius. But I wish that governors like Ron DeSantis and Greg Abbott would give Democratic governors and mayors more of a heads up, because then that would expose the hypocrisy of the Democrats, which is they don't want immigrants here either. For months, Republican governors have sent busloads of illegal.
Yeah, so you saw the looks on the faces of his guests. It was Malcolm Gladwell and Angela Rye there, two, liberal commentators.
I thought that was Gladwell.
Yeah, and I think it's unexpected for some people to hear, a black man who's presumed to be kind of a mainstream Democrat take that kind of position. But I actually do think there's a significant portion of black Americans who are frustrated that sometimes the immigration discussion and the discussion about whether or not wages are being driven down at the bottom sliver, at least of the workforce, there's not enough attention to whether or not they in particular are being undercut there. And so I'm not especially surprised that Charlamagne the God has this take. What do you make of it?
Yeah, I know. I take his point. I don't know what your impression is. It seems from watching this story unfold and the way the media talks about it, obviously it's one of those, scissor tests where everyone on one side of the issue thinks, oh my God, it's so insane that Republicans did this. They're so heartless there. How could they do this? This makes me even more emboldened as a Democrat or to support Democrats. And then Republicans do the exact opposite thing. So it's kind of hard to who won the narrative, which is an annoying conversation anyway. But I think kind of Republicans won this narrative, but it seems like there's more. They made, given the reaction from some, not everyone, but some of the people in Martha's Vineyard, you saw some of those videos. There was that MSNBC, we played it on the show yesterday, that MSNBC video of a reporter saying, like, actually, the migrants sound very grateful to be here in America. And it just,
well, yes, but that was never the issue. The issue was whether or not they are being best served in Martha's Vineyard. I think this was the part that didn't get discussed enough. Cities like Boston, larger cities and border towns, they have the resources to accept immigrants because they're typically in that position. Putting them in a place where immigrants don't typically go, where they're not the local resources to actually accommodate them, house them, have lawyers that can process their claims, it hurts the human beings involved who are here legally looking for asylum. So if you actually had an interest in human beings and had a humanist approach to this whole issue, regardless of what you think of it politically, you just simply wouldn't do that. And I think that's where conservatives made a misstep here. They didn't just fly them to a city like Boston or New York that had more resources. They chose to make an entire stunt out of it. It wasn't about Democrats and Democratic cities. It was about making a point that came actually at the expense of the families and children involved here. But you let us know what you think about it in the comments, and we will hear more from Robbie and find out what's on his radar next.